Hey, welcome friends for another episode. Welcome back for another episode of Secrets in the Saddle, all things cycling podcast with your host, Sylvie. Woo! So today I've got something pretty cool for you. We're going to talk about mental preparedness for events. But before my five tips, I got five tips for you. But before we get into there, first, make sure you follow me on Instagram. So Sylvie_cyclist. On Instagram, and you follow the podcast. So Secrets in the Saddle podcast. So make sure you're following those two accounts, because I'm going to be talking about the event that I'm participating in this weekend coming. So literally tomorrow. And I'm going to be filming, and I'm going to be basically, to my best of my abilities, I'm going to document the whole event for you, because it's the first one I've been back to that's a serious one in a while. And it's just fun because I know a lot of people decide to take on big events. And, you know, how do you prepare yourself? But before we get into that, I have some freebies for you. So I have these free downloads. If you go to askcoachsylvie.com, you can get them, implement them. So this is what's there right now, and I'm preparing other documents to add there. So as I have, I'm just going to keep adding to the freebies for you guys to go and get and implement. Okay, so for what's there now is my favorite 9 hill drills. The next one is my bike bin gear list. So I'm actually implementing that right now because I'm getting my stuff together for this weekend. And I know, like, if you get that list, a lot of things you might not have, but it's also a good thing to start checking off and finding some of these items, because they literally or will make your life a whole lot easier. And then the other one is, if you've never done a bike maintenance clinic and learned about all the tools that you need to ride with and how to change a flat and patch a tire and repair a broken chain, download this recording. You're going to get so much good information out of it. So go to and get those freebies at askcoachsylvie.com. And then also make sure you follow me on Instagram and follow the podcast. Now, let's get into the podcast. So I have 5 tips for mental preparedness for preparing an event. So I'm just going to give you a little background on myself. Is 20 years ago, I tried 2 triathlons, sprint triathlons, and then I decided that it was not for me, I call it boring. I thought it was just boring for me. Swim, bike, run, and particularly I didn't like swimming. So that just kind of made my decision so much easier. But I transferred into mountain bike racing and adventure racing. So if you've ever done like Sea to Summit or a Raid the North, or if you've watched Eco Challenge or Primal Quest, any one of those quests for the cure, these are all multi-day. You've got shorter ones like Raid Pulse, so 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, 36 hours, 4 days, 5 days, 6 days. The longest race I did was 10 days in 2006 in Utah for Primal Quest, and then I decided that was it. That was enough. I was a single mom at the time, and it was just too much for me. But the thing is that preparing yourself mentally for these types or any event, it doesn't matter what it is. It could be a sprint triathlon, or it could be a multi-day stage race. It doesn't matter. It still has the same impact on you mentally if you are not prepared, or to get prepared for these, like an event like that. Because I am a firm believer, and this is just part of my philosophy, is that, and you know, it's for anything, the more prepared you are, the better you're going to feel and the better you're going to perform. You know, so let's get into it. So like I said, this is for any type of event. It can be anything that you've put yourself out to in a sporting capacity. So I'm just going to talk about sports. Now, the first one, being prepared. Okay, so that starts from the moment you decide you're going to sign up for an event. What are you going to do? What's your training is going to look like? Do you know what the course? So typically the course will dictate kind of what your training is going to look like, right? So if you're on a flat course, you're going to be doing a lot of, time trialings flat, working on that speed, pedal stroke, efficiency. If you signed into something that's more hilly, right, like a mountain bike race or something that's like a triathlon that's in a hilly part of the country, then your commitment is going to be, or part of your good part of your training is going to be on hills. Do you agree? Yeah. Now, knowing the course is so important because, like I said, and then putting together the your schedule, your time, your training is really important. So being like more like realistic. And sometimes this doesn't come into play when you decide that you're going to sign up for the event, because there's a lot of FOMO going around where people, I've seen this all the time, where some people, just get active and then they decide to do a massive event like a Ironman. Like, if I could say anything, I laugh at these people so hard because basically you're going from zero to like the Tour de France in like a year, and that is so unrealistic. It's worth it to go baby steps, right? Sprint, start, try, sprint, Olympic, half marathon, half Ironman, things like that. And over time, like, God, we don't have to get it done in 1 year, right? You're gonna, anyways. So you have to be realistic on your goals, first of all, before you decide to pull the plug and throw the credit card down. Then it's the time you're going to train, the realization of how much time you have to dedicate. So a triathlon, you have to think about three different disciplines, right? Do you know, are you capable of swimming that far? Have you ever swam? Do you swim? Do you like swimming? Running, biking. Then of course, knowing the course, then your gear. Do you have Are you going to spend thousands and thousands of dollars getting yourself equipped for that event? Like, there are so many times when we did adventure races, and the gear list was like, oh my gosh. Like, and we had to go out and spend hundreds of dollars just getting the proper gear to participate at that event. It was, and then that's a realization. And then, of course, and then where there were certifications you had to get. So I'll give you an example. Like when I did my last race in Utah, we had to get a whitewater certification. We had to get how to ride your horse certification. We had to get a rappelling certification. So we had to show up with all of these certifications, and then they tested us. So this is like the realization of the event. So gear. So do you have the right gear? And then it's like, now you got to look at your nutrition. How are you going to start eating and changing up and eating properly for training so that you don't deplete your body, you don't wreck your body before the event, right? And then number two, we're going to elaborate the training plan. The training plan is going to be based on the event. What the event entails, is it hilly, is it flat? Do you need to get a new, like, is it next week? Is it next month? Is it like 9 months from now? Then you start working back and thinking about that, like, how many hours do you have to put in a week to get yourself prepared for this event? Do you already have a big base from years of riding or running? Are you halfway there? Then there's, like how many times a week and the type of training, and you have to periodize it. So there's a lot of things that go into play when you sign up for an event, and then that is really probably the time to decide to hire a coach to help you avoid the overwhelm, get yourself coached, probably having an accountability, somebody to count to, you know, so you don't have to think about it, right? Imagine, like, I know a lot of people go online and get these training programs, but is it tailored to you? Probably not. Definitely not, because this is just a blanket program that you can take. But if you don't know how to tailor it, then you could overtrain yourself. You could undertrain yourself. You could end up, you know, totally burnt out by your event date or even before the summer starts. So before we continue, we're going to take a mini break and you're going to hear about some amazing coaching options. All right. Thank you for sticking around. Here are some coaching options that we have happening this fall. So number one is the Cycling Skills 4-week workshop for women, or for beginners, women beginners into cycling. How it works is 4 weeks. You have, each week is dedicated to a webinar that's going to cover pedal stroke, hill climbing, strength, power, and speed, and nutrition. And alongside that, you get homework that goes along with the webinar for you to go out, test, come back. There's going to be a Q&A. And in conjunction, each webinar is set up to be interactive. So you get a presentation on a whiteboard as to what the skill looks like, then a demonstration as to what the skill looks like, and then you get on your bike and you practice some of the drills that correlate to that specific skill that's being discussed. So if it's pedal stroke, you will go in and you will be put through the drill that's going to get you thinking about a smoother pedal stroke. Then you're going to have homework. You're going to go out and do it. You're going to come back. We have a Q&A. So Thursday nights are the webinar. Q&A is Tuesday at noon. And then there's an interactive Facebook page that goes along with it and other perks. So that is over 4 weeks. You get a quick and dirty introduction to skills and to implement them in a 4-week setting. So imagine you could get all the things that you are missing from your skills base in a quick webinar. Would that be worth it to you? Go to cyclingskillspro.com. Go check it out. All right, welcome back. We have number three. Now we're just going to go like streamline straight to, so now you've got, you're getting prepared, you've got your training. Now we're going to talk about the week of, and that's my favorite because it's so important. Now the week of the event is, and I've done multiple like events, like racing, stage races. I've competed as a figure bikini competitor, and the week of is the most important of your preparation. I've done a triathlon. I've done adventure racing. So the week of is when you start. This is not a training week. This is a recovery rest week. You get on your bike a little bit, test it out, make sure it's working properly, keep the legs moving. It's not the time to go and pull out some sprints thinking you're going to get a little bit faster. That's not going to happen. You're just going to tire yourself out for the event. This is the time to rest, eat, hydrate, start putting your gear together. So if you're following me on Instagram, I am already started talking about that. I have piles of things because literally, I'm going to be packing and I want to make sure I have everything because there's nothing worse than being stressed out on event day. And one of the things that I've always told my clients and my teammates when I had my Women's Masters race team is if you can avoid any kind of stress, do it. Do it, do it. That means like waking up earlier and traveling so that you have more time before the event to get warmed up, to get prepared, to eat, to, you know, so that you're not arriving right at the time where you need to be ready. That creates a whole lot of stress. That creates like things to go wrong. Do you get me? Like when you're stressed, that is the time when everything fucking falls apart. Sorry my language, but it's true. So, getting prepared. Number two is the travel. Get yourself there early. I can't stress that enough. If you can take off work for the afternoon and travel to your destination. So my event is 4 hours away. So what I planned as I'm packing the car Thursday night, I have a bunch of work stuff I have to do Friday morning. I do not want to be packing, maybe last minute things. And so that I can leave at 12, 1 o'clock the latest, so that I can get there at 5, 6 o'clock. So I can even earlier, I'd love to get there earlier, maybe between 4 and 5. So I can A, check out the race course. B, figure out where the start finish is, where I'm going to be camping. So where are you going to be setting up? Where's your hotel? Where's your hotel in relation to your event? Going to get your race kit. All these things. You just want to be as relaxed as possible going into an event. I can't just try it. Down to the hour is what I used to do and what I still do when I organize events for people. And I think they appreciate it because nobody shows up like in a tizzy, like, oh my God, where's everything? No, it has to be ready ahead of time. And so it's just like cars packed, get into the car, have your coffee, have your bread, whatever it is, and drive to your event. Now, number five is the event. And I was just talking about scheduling the ride the course. If I can give you any more advice, is that knowing the course is like gold. If you don't have to ride on your bike, you just have to drive it to know where the turns are so you don't get lost. How many times have you heard of somebody, or maybe it happened to yourself, where you got lost on a race course because you didn't know where you're going? Oh my gosh, like that sucks. So the way you avoid that is knowing your course. So go ahead of time. If it's the day before, ride the course 2 days before, or you can drive it. It doesn't matter as long as you know where you're going. Now, getting your food on par is essential. Everything will not fall in place if you have low energy, low fuel, if you're just going to fuel up on all kinds of sugar cubes and sugar bombs, like I call them, then how do you think your stomach's going to feel on race day? Probably like shit. Your mouth's going to feel it too. Your tongue, like all this sugary stuff. So make sure you have whole food in there. And if you can, a warm up beforehand. Like also know where the start finish is. Know when you have to be at the start and get there early. Make sure if you have time to warm up, or if it's something that you can warm up as. So like when we do racing, like cycling racing, we didn't test typically warm up for road races, but crits and time trials, you had to be like 100% warmed up for your event because it is basically gas on the moment you start. You can't expect to sit there, oh, well, I'll warm up on course. No, warm up on course means that you are going to come last. Basically, you have to be warmed up and ready. So that means sitting on your trainer. Don't go for a ride. Get a trainer. Keep yourself in spot. I don't know how many people who have gone off, forgotten the time, and arrived late for their start, or missed the start, or got a flat out on the road. Like so many stories. So do yourself a favor, get a trainer, sit on stop so you're like looking at the start finish and you know when you have to get off it and get to your start line. So those, my friends, are my five tips to getting mentally prepared for your event from the moment I said that you put down the credit card. So I hope you enjoyed that. Please share that with your friends who are thinking or this is their first time event. And so that it can help them get ready for their event and be well prepared. With that, have an amazing day. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram and follow the podcast. and I'll see you on course somewhere. Thanks.